this was something that devastated the entire family. We have a very close-knit family, and it was brought a lot of joy and happiness to everyone that he interacted with. I was very angered that Mr. Hiley, at first, to cover himself, lied on my grandson, stating that he threw something at him and that he was playing an electrical elbow. My grandson never did anything like that. And it kind of appalled me that he was not man enough to tell the truth and accept responsibility for his actions. My family never felt that he intended on taking the life of my grandson, but yet he's still responsible. I was very, very close with my grandson. I was there when he was born. I was the second to hold him. I was a part of his life from the time he was born up until the morning of the day of life. He experienced what he experienced.
He got spooked in, and I don't even have my son anymore because of what's happened. All we realize is what he's done and the pain he's put me and my family through. And I hope that he can sense a little bit of that pain because he's going to miss out on some of his children's life. But I don't have any kind of hate for him or anything like that. I forgive him for what he did because I don't think it was intentional. But even still, I just hope he knows how much it hurt. Thank you.
Thank you. I'd like to say something to both of you. Number one, I know that Ms. Swanson would not have agreed to this plea and sentence agreement without your approval. You folks, let me say this. As Christians, you know how to walk the walk. And you see, we're not supposed to outlive our children and our grandchildren. And I've often said that I would rather go tomorrow than outlive tomorrow. And the fact that you have been able to reconcile your strong feelings in accordance with your faith is telling you.